Good morning once again, everyone. We already have a 5-minute conversation and now we are ready to start. I'm able to see here around 50 people here, and that's superb. So let us start now. Look at this young child, how is diving into water. We need to dive into a great learning. Are you all ready? Because today it is going to be a really interesting and we are going to have it a very practical session. You need to stay with me. You need to act with me. You need to be involved into that. So rest assured you are free for the next half an hour, because this session might last for 40 minutes, 45 minutes, but this is going to be that. So let's get ahead now. Sit straight to dive into the deep learning. Keep your notebook pen ready. And you know me, I'm your coach, Pankaj Asija. I'm Leadership Mindset Strategist, Peak Performance Expert, Professional Speaker, Member of APSS, Member of PSAI, Professional Speaker Association of India, Professional Speaker Coach and Founder of PSL Institute. And I'm very happy to see you today. Today we are going to do the secret of success, the untold secret which you never ever know, the untold secret. And these secrets I have understood after investing a lot of time in learning. And basically I did not understand when I learned, I understood when I started implementing. You will surely agree with me, when we start implementing the things, then only we get to know the power of this. You will also realize the power of these, all the things which you'll be getting today, the nuggets of the secrets which you'll be getting today. You'll realize the power of this once you go and you implement it. Implementation is a power. Understand, my dear friends, implementation is the power. So let's go. See, today what I'm going to tell you is success. Success is various type of. Like some people think achieving a dream life, achieving goal is a success. For someone, only earning 2 times meal might be the success. Whatever the success is for you, it might be buying a luxury car, big bungalow or something. It might be arranging 2 times meal for your family. It might be buying a bike or all the daily necessities. But my dear friend, the formula of success is same, which I'm going to tell you. You need to take some steps, whatever I tell you, you need to take these steps. And every day when you take these steps, I assure whatever success is for you, you will be achieving that. So let's get started. The first thing comes here, take responsibility. Now you must be thinking, what is the meaning of taking responsibility? Let me make you understand. What you need to do is take your notebook pen. I trust you already have your notebook pen. Yes, you do need to write it. Take your notebook pen with you. Yeah, take your notebook pen with you. If you have taken your notebook pen, write down 5 things which you cannot do. I mean, your limiting beliefs, the 5 limiting beliefs which you think you cannot do. 5 limiting beliefs which you think you cannot do. Like it can be, I cannot swim. It can be, I cannot speak in English. It can be, I cannot speak in front of people. Some 5 limiting beliefs which you think you cannot do. 5 limiting beliefs which you think you cannot do. Written? Write down the 5 limiting beliefs, and you need to write in this way. I cannot swim. I cannot speak. I cannot face people. Something like that. 5. Now, tell these 5 limiting beliefs that I cannot do this. Ye 5 limiting beliefs apne saath wale partner ko bataein. Aapke saath mein koi bhi ho aapka. They can be. You need to tell this 5 limiting beliefs to your partner sitting next to you. Might be your husband, wife, kids. Or if there is no one, no worry. Consider somebody sitting next to you and you go and tell the person as it is, this line. I cannot swim. I cannot write. Something like that. Go and tell it. Or you can tell this mobile phone. Or you can just speak it. But if you consider there is somebody sitting next to you and you go and tell it, then it would be nice. Once you have done it, once you have spoken this, I cannot do that. Once you have spoken that, do let me know. Done it? Told that any 5 limiting beliefs, if you have written and told your partner, type D in the chat box if you have done it. Type D in the chat box if you have done it. If you have told it, written and told, because you need to tell also. Only writing will not help you. You need to tell also. Done. Now speak these 5 limiting beliefs once again. I cannot swim. I cannot speak. I cannot face people. Speak these 5 limiting beliefs. Go and tell it. Go and speak. Done. And if you have done it, my dear friends, if all of you have done it, then what you need to do, the second step. This time you spoke with I cannot, but now replace this cannot with will not. Replace this cannot with will not. And if you have said earlier, I cannot face people, now say, I will not face people, I will not speak, I cannot speak. In place of I cannot speak, say, I will not speak, I will not swim, I will not face people. Now replace it with will. Replace cannot with will not. Go and do it and speak it. First write it down and then speak it. Just tell your friend, hey, I will not do this. Hey, I will not do this. You feel something? Just go and speak it. Hey, I will not do this. Do you feel something? Do you feel the difference? How many of you feel speaking will not is very difficult? Cannot was easy. How many of you feel speaking will not is difficult? Speaking will not is difficult. If you feel speaking difficult, speaking will not is a difficult, type F in the chat box. Type F in the chat box. How many of you feel that speaking will not is difficult? It's difficult. And there is some change of feeling. Cannot was easy. You could easily go and speak that. But will not is very difficult. I cannot speak that. That's a secret, my dear friend. That's a secret. What you need to do is you need to understand now this very deeply. When you say I cannot, your brain thinks you're making an excuse. Your brain thinks you're making an excuse. I cannot do this. I cannot do this. Brain thinks you're making an excuse and brain accepts it. Okay, that's fine. That's comfortable. In this, you're not challenging your brain. You're not taking the responsibility. You are just giving up. That's very, very easy. Whenever you say, I cannot do that, that's very, very easy. Now, second thing, when you say, I will not speak or I will not swim, when you use will not, the brain gets a challenge. Brain thinks, no, this is a challenge for me. Why will I not? I will do it. I will do it. The feeling comes, I will do it. So my dear friends, today onwards, what you need to do is you need to take responsibility. Will is a word of taking responsibility. Can and cannot is a word of leaving the responsibility and just making excuses. And when you take responsibility, your entire body becomes capable of doing that. So this is very, very simple. I call it take responsibility. The first thing what you learn here is take responsibility. Very simple. Take responsibility. How many of you understand it? If you understand it, type U in the chat box, because let me know that if you understand that. Take responsibility. And for this very simple thing is there, whenever you want to speak, cannot, in place of that, you need to speak, will not. Whenever you feel like speaking, cannot, in place of that, you need to speak, or will not. Sometimes we say, I cannot manage money. Mind says, okay, mind does not give you any option to make the money or manage money. But when you say, I can easily manage money, I will manage money, then mind says, okay, now mind will start thinking how to manage money. So we should say, I will do it, in place of saying, I cannot do it. Because when you say, I cannot do it, the mind thinks it is an excuse and mind just put the things right and mind does not take anything on that. I think this is very, very clear and this is super easy, super easy. The second thing what you need to do is you need to ask what you want. Have you ever asked what you want? First, write on the paper, what do you exactly want? See, I want not more than, like, not less than and not more. 10 lakh per month income is enough, good, pretty good for me. And I want to spend more time with my family. So I ask the universe, I want to spend more time with my family. I ask the universe, I want 10 lakh rupees per month, right? I ask this universe, have you ever asked this universe, what do you want? And do you ask it regularly? Do you ask it regularly? Have you ever asked, what do you want? Have you ever asked, what do you want? If you have never asked, the first thing what you need to do today is you need to start asking. The first thing, take responsibility. Second, start asking what you want. See, you want Mercedes, you want to get selected somewhere, you need to go and ask. Let me tell you a very simple incident of my life. In year 2005, I started my institute by name of PSCL. And that time my family was not up to that level. We were not making money. I would say we were hand-to-mouth family, or sometimes we were not having anything in the mouth. So we were not having money at all. So 2005, I started my institute, and till 2011 and 12, I worked so hard. I mean, that's called a work hard. No, I generally think like work hard will never ever give you success. Yes, my dear friends, work hard will never give you success. 2005 to 2012, I worked so hard. I worked for around 14 to 15 hours a day. 15 hours a day. Just imagine, 15 hours a day. And I used to take a lot of classes. I used to teach a lot of students and would work on getting quality. I would give advertisement in newspaper, billboards, and the big signboards, hoardings, everything. I had done it. But I was not able to make money. I was not able to spend time with my family because I was not asking. I was not asking the God, what do I want? That time I was asking only one thing. I need some money. I need some money to run my family. I need some money to run my family. So God was giving me this only. But in 2012, I handed over myself to a coach. That's my success coach, Jack Enfield. I have already told, like, how many of you know that Jack Enfield has been my guru? So I handed over myself to Jack Enfield and I started learning from Jack. Jack told me very first thing, Pankaj, for success, what you need to do is you need to go and ask this universe, what do I want? I said, okay, I'm asking, I need some money to run my family. So he asked, are you getting money more than the running? I said, no, I'm not getting money. I said, once I asked, I need a small car. So I got Maruti 800. I asked, he said, then now write on a paper. And every morning you need to go and ask, what do I want? So every morning I started asking, I want to spend time with my family and want to make money and want to shift in a bigger house. Every morning I used to do it. And to your surprise, my dear friend, within 6 months, we were in a bigger house. Earlier, my house size was 35 yard. Then it was 110 yard. And I kept on asking this. And then we shifted to a posh area of a city, then to a 200 yard house and having all the luxury now. I mean, now we are making money more than hand to mouth. And I spend more time with my family. You see, today is Saturday, completely with the family. Sunday, completely with the family. Moreover, I reach my office in the morning, 10 o'clock. I come back from my office in the evening at 5 o'clock. I get to spend more time with my family. You understand? And let me tell you a secret, my dear friends. I always used to tell God, the day I become father, I want to spend more time with my baby. As long as my baby does not go to school, as long as my baby is at home, I want to spend more time with my baby. And you know what? My son was born during COVID. So I was completely with my son. And now, he was born on 1st August. He's just going to be a 1 year old now. He was born on 1st August. I spent first 3 months, 24/7 with my son. Isn't it amazing? I think this is a dream of many. This is a dream of many man, many father. So understand, my dear friends, have you ever asked? Now, come and tell me. Have you ever asked, what do you want? If you have ever asked, what do you want? Type A. If you have never asked, then type N. Every day you need to ask God. You need to ask this universal power. Every day. It's not one day. It's every day. And if you're not asking, my dear friend, I'm telling you're living and missing a lot of things in the life. It's very, very essential to ask, what do you want? Now ask, what do I want? I want to have a big bungalow. I want to have a 5 lakh income every month. And I want to have 200 students every week. Go and ask it. And once you start asking, now Varun, this is vague. You have to be definite, not the infinite. When you say, I want to be number one, what? Number one, coach of which field? Say, you have to be very sure. Don't say, I want money. How much money? What is your business? You need to say, I want to be a number one in my city, in my business. I want to be number one in state. I want to be number one in my business and this. So you basically don't want to be number one. What you want your business to be number one by in city, then state, and then the country, right? So every morning you need to do this. And what you need to do is you don't only have to do that. You'll have to do something else, which I'll be telling you today. That's a very, very important thing. So now take one paper and write down what all you want. Take one paper and write down what all you want. And don't think, don't write like, I want to marry Mukesh Ambani's daughter. She's already married. Don't say like that. It should be achievable. It should not be, means something which is not right now achievable. We can definitely step by step, we can start asking more things. I could not directly ask God to give me a 1,000-yard house. No, I cannot even manage 1,000-yard house. I asked God to give me the pretty good house. So I got 110-yard. And then I started asking, now I want to shift in the bigger area and good sector. So we shifted there. There I sat like, now I want a house of around 200 and 250-yard. And you know what? I got 200-yard. I wanted a corner house. I got that. I wanted a garden in the house. I got that. My dear friends, we need to be definite. Don't be vague. Don't have blurred vision. Have a very, very clear vision. So very simple thing. Our first thing, you need to go and ask. But many of you might not have asked, and many of you might not be even clear what you want. How many of you are not even yet 100% clear what do I want? How many of you are not clear that what do you want? If you're not 100% clear, type N in the chat box. Let me see how many of you are not clear with a 100% things like what do I want? What do you want? My God. Hey, Khushi Gill says she's not clear. Mangal Prasad, not clear. Kalyani, not clear. My God. Go. Have the clarity. Have clarity. That's very, very important. And whatever you ask, you start attracting. Do you think you are wearing the clothes? Do you think you are wearing the clothes with your choice? How many of you think you are wearing the clothes with your choice? How many of you think you are wearing the clothes with your choice? How many of the things we are wearing the clothes? I want to travel the world and he. Financial independent. This has to be very clear. How much money do you want? Financial independent. How many of you are wearing the clothes with your choice? If you are wearing the clothes with your choice, type M in the chat box. Type M in the chat box. We are having 58 people. Let me see. Now, hold your breath. This is your misconception if you think you are wearing the clothes with your choice. No, you are 100% wrong. Now you must be thinking, no, Pankaj, I am wearing the clothes with my choice. No, you are 100% wrong. Let me ask one more thing. You went market, why did you choose? According to the style which suits you, that's very simple. Like, that's also your choice only. Why did you choose this particular outfit? Because you liked it. You'll say you liked it. Okay, one more question. One more thing. You every time go market and say, I already have this color, right? Some one color, you think like, I already have this color. Now I will not buy this color, right? But now just visualize your wardrobe and find out one color, one common color is in your 80% of the dresses. It might be black, white, it might be blue, green, pink. One common color is in one color, one particular color, which you always like, is in your 80% of dresses. Kalyani says it is red. Achuthun says it is blue. Yeah, come, write down your color, right? But every time you go market and say, this time I will not buy this color. Yes or no? It happens, no? Every time you go market and you say, I will not buy this color now because I have this color a lot at my home. I will never buy it. But you still buy that color. How many of you agree with me? Every time you go market and say, this time I will not buy this color, but you still buy that color. And one more common thing is there. One more common thing. You might have just realized it. Before that, you never realized it. One more thing I'm going to tell you now. You'll be completely surprised. You think every time you go and choose a different style of a cloth? No. Your outfit is not of different style. Your 70 to 80% of the outfit is of same style. Let's say it can be little different. Let's say you like to wear, if you are female, you like to wear kurti and the jeans. So it can be kurti and palazzo. It can be kurti and a trouser. It can be something relevant to that. And let's say you always like to wear formals, if you're male, formal. But you buy a t-shirt, you think your t-shirt is a casual, you'll find your t-shirt also somehow formal. Your jeans might be somehow formal. You'll not buy the funky shoes now. You'll buy even the sports shoes in the formal way. How many of you have just realized it? Have you just realized this? If you have just realized this, type R in the chat box. Now let me tell you, why does this happen? Do you still think that you are wearing something of your choice? No. So what is this? What? How do you choose the clothes and how do you wear? It is not only about the clothes. It happens. Everything happening in your life is not happening through your choice, my dear friends. It happens. See, we have subconscious brain. And our subconscious brain is very powerful. But the one thing in the subconscious brain is we do not use subconscious brain in our 99% of the life. We use only 1%, but subconscious brain does 95% things in our life, 95% thing. Another thing in the subconscious brain, it is half sleeping brain. You cannot use it to think. This brain cannot be used to think. Another thing, this brain does not understand words. This only understands images, photographs. But it is sad, whatever is in your mind, whatever is in your subconscious mind, not in every brain, it always comes true. It is sad, we every day have 6,200 thoughts. And we are the product of our own thoughts. You are wearing the clothes by the choice of your thoughts, not by you. Let's say in the childhood, you have seen somebody. Let me give you an example. When I was growing up, in my entire family, people used to wear, loose shirt and a trouser. And then they started wearing jeans and common t-shirt. But one buddy in my family, one person, my uncle, my Fufaji in Delhi, he's the one who was doing job. He's the one who used to wear on the routine basis suit. Two-piece suit, coat, pant, tie. And you'll be surprised, my dear friends. I never realized it, but I started wearing coat, pant, tie in my routine every day whenever I used to go to office. Since 2005, I have been every day wearing coat, pant, tie and going to office. That definitely, I live in a North India, so in summer I cannot wear coat, but otherwise I every day do that. And this I realized when I became the mentee of when I started learning from Tony Robbins, Anthony Robbins. He made me realize that. The first, I started talking like my Fufaji. I started wearing clothes like him. I started having that same type of style and the thought process. You know why? In my childhood, when everyone was wearing different, he was a different person. Everyone was wearing same type of clothes, but he was a little different. He went into my subconscious mind. And whenever I went market, I did not buy the clothes of my choice. I bought the clothes of his choice. Reason? Because he was there in my subconscious mind planning everything. And this happens in everything. This happens in car. This happens in like you're buying a wristwatch. This happens in everything. Let me tell you, my dear friends, one thing. I don't want to spend money and I do not like to waste money on the artificial things today. But you know what? I've already invested around 30 lakh rupees on buying just a wristwatch. I have Rolex, I have Rado, the Rolex which comes of 24, 25 lakh rupees, and Rado which is of around 2.2 lakh rupees. And I bought it in 2013, 14. Understand my point here is. But today I think how stupid I was. Why did I buy? I did not buy because I wanted to buy. I bought because these were then in my subconscious mind. My subconscious mind was having one thought. When rich people wear these things, and now Pankaj, you are becoming a rich, you need to go and buy that. So this was there in my subconscious mind. The Rado, in my childhood, I heard, Ghadi ho to Rado, Ghadi ho to Prado. So I bought the Rado. I bought the Rolex. This is what, when you something goes in your subconscious mind, it basically comes true. So you're wearing the clothes, even you speak. Sometimes, have you ever realized you don't want to get angry, you don't want to scold somebody, but by chance, by mistake, you scold, and right after scolding, you realize, no, I should not have said this. Ever realize that? You feel like, no, I should not have said that. How many of you have ever realized that? Yeah, this I did not want to do it, but you did it by mistake. You know what? Because this was there in your subconscious mind. This was there in your subconscious mind. This was present in your thoughts someday or the other. And that's why we always say we need to learn to manage our thoughts, to control our thoughts, because our thoughts are very powerful. Because our thoughts are coming from our subconscious mind. Even if you are not thinking, there is something going in your subconscious mind. Even while sleeping, you are thinking that is going in your subconscious mind. Let me tell you, when you go and sleep, most of the time, I've seen a lot of people, I've done the survey on the 500 people, and I got to know one thing. Why middle-class families are middle-class? Because middle-class families sleep having a lot of tensions. They sleep with one mindset, will I be able to manage this? Will I be able to manage that? And blah, 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 blah thing. They sleep like that. So their subconscious mind start creating the problems they're thinking. And next day they face the problem. Otherwise, in some days they start facing the problem. And then you realize that you think you forecasted, you think you predicted it. Then you think, see, I knew this problem would come. How many of you have ever felt it? If you felt it, type F in the chat box. Let me see that. So Panda is very clear. If you want to be rich, if you want to be successful, if you want to go to the next level in the life, then first you have to start going from here. You need to control your thoughts. Now, do you think we can master our thoughts? Do you think we can master our thoughts? Do you think we can master our thoughts? Yes, we can completely control our thoughts, my dear friend. 6,200 thoughts coming every day in the mind, but 6,200 things do not become true. No. If all 6,200 things becomes true, then anything can happen. Only the thing which travels in our subconscious mind, which our mind believes, that becomes true. That becomes true. So now let me show something to you. Let me show something to you. You know, the session can be way longer and longer. I can teach you today how to master the thoughts. But I'll not be teaching everything. No. Don't expect me to teach you everything today. If I teach you everything today, what will you learn in the next class? So, but today I'm going to do one experiment with you all. If you're ready to do this experiment, particularly of thoughts, and if you feel amazed after this experiment, you need to, you might have got this link from LinkedIn, Facebook, or from my WhatsApp group, or you might have already attended my any 5 days training, or you might be the part of my advanced public speaking program. You might be the student at my institute, PSCL. So that's why you have come here and started attending this workshop, right? So whatever the source is, you need to go and write down how you felt about the program today. You need to record a small video and say how powerful this program was by me. This one thing I'm going to do with you. Ready to take this exercise? Ready to do this next 2 minute experiment? If you're ready, type R in the chat box. I am really ready and excited to do that, because I know after this, just 2 minutes of the experiment, your life is going to change. But you need to promise me that you're going to implement that. And if you don't implement, it is not going to work for you. That's great. So everyone has come and told me, yes, you are ready to do that. So let's go ahead, my dear, all the friends. So Look at your hand. You have hand. You have your wrist, right? You have your wrist. And on the wrist, you are having this line. You're having this line. It is visible here. Okay, this line. Now, both the lines do like this. Do like this, both. These lines. Both lines same at the same part. And then do. And then see. Check out your which hand is taller, bigger. And tell me, your left hand or right hand, which hand do you think this is a taller, left or right hand? Go and type in a chat box, which hand do you think is the taller, is the bigger? Left hand, okay. Left, left, left. And if you think both are equal, you can type E. If your hand both are equal, type E. Okay, great, some equal. Now do it once again. Now, whatever I say, you need to do that. Take your shorter hand, or you can take your right hand or left hand. Take your shorter hand, the hand which is smaller, and if you think your both hands are equal, then take, in that case, you can take your right or left, any of the hand. Otherwise, take any smaller hand, take which hand is smaller. Otherwise, take right hand, you can take, if your both hands are equal, you can take right hand. Else take smaller hand, take smaller hand, take smaller hand. Now talk to your hand the way I do it. First you see me, then you do that. Now tell your hand, you are becoming bigger. Hey hand, you're becoming bigger. Yes, I can see you're becoming bigger. While speaking, you need to visualize your hand is becoming bigger. You need to visualize your hand is becoming bigger. Just tell your hand, hey, you are becoming bigger. I can see, I can feel you're becoming bigger. Now take, I've just shown you what to do. Take your hand, breathe in, breathe out, close your eyes once. See your hand is becoming bigger, visualize your hand is becoming bigger. Open your eyes, look at your hand and tell your hand, you're becoming bigger, you're becoming bigger. You're becoming bigger. Believe it. You're becoming bigger. You have become bigger. You have become bigger now. I can see you're becoming bigger. You have become bigger. You have become bigger. Amazed. You have become bigger. You have become bigger. Now take your hand once again. Touch these two lines and do it now this. Do it in this way. Do it in this way. Surprised? How many of you felt that your hand has become bigger? If you have felt this, your hand has become bigger, type F in the chat box. Let me know. Type F in the chat box. Kalyani, Shakti, Medha. Yes. Surprised, amazed. This is the power in the visualization. Actually, in this process, you might have started thinking in the beginning, you might have started thinking, I cannot believe that. I cannot believe that. This cannot happen. If you doubted even a 1%, then it did not happen. But if you trusted me, it definitely happened. It happens, my dear friends. And that's a magic. And let me tell you, my dear friends, this is called visualization. But in the visualization, what you need to do is you need to speak everything in present continuous and present indefinite tense. Mean, in place of saying, I want to have a bungalow, you need to say, I'm having a bungalow. Everyone, close your eyes and say, I'm having great complete image. close your eyes, speak with me. I'm having a white color 2000 yard big bungalow. Big pillars are standing and the bungalow looks lavish. As soon as you enter from a main gate, which is very tall, you see the fleet of 5 luxury cars. 2 Mercedes Maybach, 1 BMW, Range Rover, Jaguar. And then on your right hand side, you see there is a lush green garden with a swimming pool. And I can see my son taking bath in that swimming pool. My wife is standing outside the swimming pool, capturing the photograph of my son. 2 dogs, furry lot, long-haired dog. They're looking at my son and barking. The white color, big bungalow. Like this, you need to every day visualize it in present, indefinite, and a continuous tense. Everything in a present. I'm getting 200 students every month. You have to do that. I'm spending time with the family. You'll have to do this. And when you close your eyes and visualize it, you start achieving it. Everyone, close your eyes. Whatever you had written on the paper, whatever you started asking this universe, now close your eyes and start asking. Start believing that this is happening. This is the power of visualization. It could make your hand bigger. It can make anything possible. Close your eyes and visualize you are already achieving whatever you want. You are achieving 5 lakh rupees per month income. Now, say like on every first of every month, my account is credited with the 5 lakh. Visualize it. And this would seriously happen. Everything to be in the present continuous tense. And this can happen. This is untold secret of success, my dear friends. I repeat it. Untold secret. I go and do it once again, but you'll have to do it every day. First thing was take responsibility. Second, ask what you want. You have to be clear what you want, definite what you want. Then whatever you ask, you start attracting. You need to control your thoughts, and this can be possible when you close your eyes and visualize. And when you visualize it, you get whatever you want because you have already made your hand bigger. So this is possible, my dear friends. And I want you to do it. That's a very simple thing. And when you do it every day, it will hardly take you 15 minutes in a day. And if you do it 2 times, before sleeping and before starting a day, let me tell you, this will happen faster. Great. Superb. How many of you felt this is amazing? Like, how many of you felt this amazing sessions? How many of you felt that amazed? How many of you are really amazed? How many of you are really amazed, right? Superb. So, my dear friends, whatever the source you have joined through, see you. If you are already the student of any of my program, then see you at your own timing from Monday. Fine. I want you to achieve your success in the next 6 months. You do achieve whatever you want. And do remember, if you want to become a digital coach, want to spend more time and want to make more money, then tomorrow I'm taking one session at 3 o'clock, coaching ecosystem. I will be sharing a secret how you can basically become a powerful coach without spending a single money. Fine. So bye-bye. Take care. Love you, everyone. Love you. Bye. Love you.